Blessed Mother, intercede for us, that we may enter into this Mass as if it were our last Mass, and the last Mass, and our only Mass. Remember, the most gracious Virgin Mary, that ever was a child, that anyone who led to that confession, the Lord thy God, saw thy intercession, his love for me, inspired by his confidence, I climbed to be a Virgin of Virgins, my Mother, to thee do I come, for thee I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother, the Word of God, despise thy petitions, but in thy mercy, hear and answer them. Amen. The souls of the saints are rejoicing in heaven, the saints who follow the footsteps of Christ, and since the love of him, they shed their blood, they now exult with Christ forever. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Friends, we gather this morning to celebrate the feast of the first martyrs of the Holy Roman Church. This was a great many martyrs who were Christians who were martyred under the persecution of Nero in the first century, late in the first century. And so we ask them to pray for us today, that in the midst of the challenges of our day, that we may persevere in our faith, and so give good witness to Jesus Christ. So, brothers and sisters, let us call to mind our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery. Your sins heal and try to part. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Came to call sinners. Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Mighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who consecrated the abundant first fruits of the Roman Church by the blood of the martyrs, grant, we pray, that with firm courage we may together draw strength from so great a struggle, and ever rejoice at the triumph of faithful love through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
From the book of the prophet Amos. Hear this word, O children of Israel, that the Lord pronounces over you, over the whole family that I brought up from the land of Egypt. You alone have I favored, more than all the families of the earth. Therefore I will punish you for all your crimes. Do two walk together unless they have agreed? Does a lion roar in the forest when it has no prey? Does a young lion cry out when it's dead unless it has seized something? Is a bird brought to earth by a snare when there is no lure for it? Does a snare spring out from the ground without catching anything? If the trumpet sounds in a city, will the people not be frightened? If evil befalls the city, has not the Lord caused it? Indeed, the Lord God does nothing without revealing his plan to his servants, the prophets. The lion roars, who will not be afraid? The Lord God speaks, who will not prophesy? I brought upon you such upheaval as when God overthrew Sodom and Gomorrah. You were like a brand plucked from the fire, yet you returned not to me, says the Lord. So now I will deal with you in my own way, O Israel. And since I will deal thus with you, prepare to meet your God, O Israel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
At dawn, I bring my plea expectantly before you, for you, O God, delight not in wickedness. No evil man remains with you. The arrogant may not stand in your sight.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
You hate all evildoers. You destroy all who speak falsehood. The bloodthirsty and the deceitful the Lord abhors.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
But I, because of your abundant mercy, will enter your house. I will worship at your holy temple in fear of you, O God, O Lord.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
Especially when the cross does indeed become very heavy. And just as I said, all of the martyrs of the first martyrs of the Church of Rome, they weren't necessarily all martyred in the same time and place. And yet they all share this feast day because they all lay down their lives together with Pope and with Christ. And so we have to have that courage of remembering that when our cross becomes heavy, that we do not carry it alone. And that is why we draw near to Christ. And we keep taking one step at a time. Even if it seems like we're walking on water. You see what I was going to do? Right? But that we keep our eyes on Christ and keep moving forward. And he does keep drawing us forward. He is always drawing us forward. Even in this this challenging first reading from the prophet Amos, as we shift to the prophet Amos in the lectionary, we shift to the prophet Amos in a week in which we have a number of saints in the calendar. And interestingly enough, this is one of those weeks that is bookended. On Monday and Friday, we have big feast days where we're going to set the rest of the lectionary aside. And they're both feasts of apostles, by the way. Peter and Paul yesterday on Monday, and then on Friday, we'll celebrate St. Thomas. And so it's good for us to ask the apostles to pray for us as we look at, okay, we're only going to get about 3 readings of Amos. And Amos can be challenging because he is calling out injustice. And he's calling out injustice not against the bad guys who are oppressing Israel. We're very good at naming the bad guys who are oppressing us. He's calling Israel, calling God's people to turn from their injustice. And the first part of the reading today, if we were to read it by itself without what we'll read in the coming days, doesn't seem real hopeful. It can seem discouraging. It can seem like, yeah, this is just an awful situation that's created. But part of the call to repentance, and the prophets really proceed in this way as they were simply speaking the word of God that was given to them, is that it's worth taking the time to stop and realize the weight of sin. To realize, as St. Paul says, that the wages of sin is death. That our selfish choices breed injustice. And that injustice causes suffering. But perhaps even more importantly, that it causes suffering to the one who loves us perfectly. That it hurts our God, and it hurts our relationship with him. And yeah, we do have longer readings that sort of stay in this place of letting us feel the weight of our sin. Because the Lord wants us, in a very real way, he carried that cross for us, and so he wants us beneath that cross with him. Not so that we stay there, but so that we can truly lay down our lives with him, so that we can truly live with him, that we can discover that new life. And so while it may not seem like it right now, it will become clear in the coming days that this prophecy of Amos is a call to conversion. It's saying, yes, understand the weight of your sin. Now turn from it. Turn back to me. It's incredibly striking that right after this prophecy in which our Lord is calling out injustice, that we pray that psalm, lead me, Lord, in your justice. Lead me, Lord, in your justice. That we respond with a heart that desires to change. Not just desires everything else around us to change. That we desire our own actions, our own lives to change. Because we desire to please our God, to love him in return, for he has loved us perfectly. And so let us indeed follow the witness of the saints who have gone before us. That is what I find so striking about that these are saints that we celebrate today who in a very real way followed in the footsteps of Peter, who, as I reflected on yesterday, They knew that the journey with Christ involves a lot of stumbling and falling and getting back up and calling on the Lord and letting Him pick us back up. Striking that we often speak about. Well, just get back up when you fall. Well, we do need to make that choice, right? Make a firm choice with our will to get back up. But it's striking that the first thing that Peter does when he falls, when he sinks, isn't to get up by his own power, as if he could literally pull himself up by the waves. The first thing he does is call on Jesus. Lord, save me. Today's prophecy is meant to remind us that we are in need of saving. And it's striking then that the gospel reminds us that He can save us. So we place all of our prayers in the hands of our loving Father as we pray for the whole church, for Francis, our Pope, Daniel, our Bishop, for all the clergy and all the faithful. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our world, for an increase in peace, justice, and respect for all human life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our community, especially any among us who may be sick, suffering, hurting in any way, that they may know the consolation of Jesus Christ crucified and the hope of His resurrection. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for for those of Donna Keener for whom this Mass is being offered, and for all of those near and dear to our own hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the freedom and purification of the Church.
Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke and we humbly pray. And do thou, the Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all evil spirits, who wander through the world seeking the ruin of souls.
With loving confidence, Heavenly Father, we entrust all of our prayers to you, trusting your holy will for your good and your love endures forever. We ask all of these things for Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, the fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, that will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, the fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
God, who graciously accomplished the effects of your mysteries, receive, Holy Father, the offerings we bring in commemoration of the holy martyrs, and grant that we, your servants, may be found steadfast in confessing your name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, for the blood of your blessed martyrs of Rome, poured out like Christ to glorify your name, shows forth your marvelous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear your witness through Christ our Lord. And so with the powers of heaven we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end, Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your promise and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Daniel, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our church, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room,
but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. About the current protocol for the communion. When you come forward into the center aisle, please watch for the floor markings as they're there to indicate where to stand to provide sufficient space to those in front of you and behind you. Please come forward single file. For daily mass, we'll come forward to the side of the pad at the altar rail on the St. Louis side. With the hall reception of Holy Communion, will be at the altar rail right. Purify and sanitize my hands, as well as the front row and anyone else who needs me to come to them. Also, when you come to the front, you can either stand or kneel, as is your choice. Please sanitize your hands as you come forward. Wear your mask, as I will be wearing mine. You can simply pull it up or down to receive our Lord, and then replace it. Union Antiphon. It is you who have stood by me. spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you in my soul. Whether or not I can now receive you sacramentally, come please spiritually into my heart. As though you were already there, I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Permit not that I should ever be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who in your holy martyrs have wonderfully made known the mystery of the cross, graciously grant that drawing strength from this sacrifice, we may cling faithfully to Christ and labor in the church for the salvation of all, through Christ our Lord. Just to make an announcement, I'll try to remind people throughout the daily masses, because you never know who's planning to come on Friday, but in case anyone isn't expecting it or didn't see it in the announcement, just to remind you that Friday is, it's not our Independence Day Mass, because it's a feast of St. Thomas, but it's sort of the special Mass that's set aside for us to pray for our nation. So we'll be at 9 a.m., as we often do on those civic holidays. So, like I said, you might have been thrown off by that because it's not actually the 4th of July, but please be aware that the Mass on Friday is at 9 a.m. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Before the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Hail Mary, full of grace,